get about 10 pages of notes from some of that research I've been doing the last 2 weeks, okay? And I'm sorry if it's a little all over the place. A lot of the questions are related to the trustees, okay? Over the last 2 weeks, just to give reference, there was a discussion brought up about the hiring of a rehiring of an employee. And I was given the video from the last meeting, so I rewatched it 8 times to make sure the timeline is correct and that I understand everything, okay? It's my understanding that our trustees met, I'm guessing from, again, a comment made by one of them in a private session, okay? The discussion came up of having the IT department audited. That's the best way I can just understand it. The IT, head of IT, the very next day resigns, okay? And further discussion throughout the meeting, he resigned because A, he felt disrespected, and stated in his resignation letter, he cannot work with the person who's in charge of IT, which is Mr. Rosen. What I've come to learn is each of our trustees is in charge of a different area. What I've also come to learn, in other townships around us, our administrator is in charge of the areas. Our administrator reports to the trustees. We don't operate that way. I don't know why, I don't know, but the administrator does all that needs with them. So, anyway, just, again, things I've learned. I've talked to at least one trustee in each of our surrounding townships, Delhi, Coleraine, and Springfield Township. Also, furthering my looking and understanding things, I've talked to two auditors for major companies in Cincinnati with over 40 years of experience between them, one head of IT, one current judge, two former judges, one head of HR for their local hospital, and again, the trustees outside of Miami Township. It is a common practice to have areas audited, okay? Talking with these people in IT, let me back up. Sorry. So this IT person we have is named Mr. Taylor. I wouldn't know this Mr. Taylor or the job he's done in the township if he walked in front of me. I'm not questioning the job he's done. My point is questioning our policies and what's going on here, okay? A red flag, though, does come up when someone in IT, and this comes from these auditors, and this comes from two people in HR. Why would someone resign the next day? The trustees that I talked to said, how did he find out? That's an executive session. So someone came out of executive session, and I don't know if that's common practice to go and tell someone. My understanding is it is an ethics violation to come out of joint executive sessions and talk about anything. Again, I can be wrong about what I have. This is all new to me. I don't know. So when someone quits or resigns on the spot, red flags can be thrown up, from my understanding. And I also don't understand why we're opposed to an audit of an IT division. And is that something any of you can answer? Because Mr. Redinger and Mr. Blanton fought very hard at this last meeting to rehire this person without putting out any type of job posting, which is another very common practice. Why 2 months later? I mean, what happened here is my question.
I think Mr. Taylor felt disrespected. I don't think his supervisor went to him one time and asked him any questions.
Okay, that's not my question.
You said, why did he leave?
No, I didn't. I said, why are you afraid of an audit?
Which he's went through an audit with the fire department.
That's apparently why he quit, because he didn't want his area audited.
I don't think he didn't want to audit. He didn't want to.